What is going on, y'all? It's your boy. I pull up to the house and I'm bringing you yet another video featuring the Georgia State Panthers in my offline dynasty on NCAA Football 14 featuring the Georgia State Panthers. And look at that. We are the number three team in the nation. That is what's up. BCS should be coming out pretty soon as far as the initial rankings as we're in week eight. And we're up to three already. How we're not number one, I don't know. But, I mean, we've been knocking off ranked opponent after ranked opponent. But today's video is actually our second conference scheduled game facing Texas State. And I'm looking forward. I'm trying to get to the number two ranked team in the nation spot. So what I did is I went into the schedule, and I'm going to simulate the number two team. As you see, it's Louisville. And I'm going to see if they can get this loss and give me a chance to get to number two in the nation and get us in the fast track to plan for the national championship. And look at that. UCF, Central Florida knocks off Louisville. That's what's up. They are now 6-1. They're going to drop down for sure because they lost to an unranked opponent. And in this game, it's going to actually give me a chance to be the number two team in the country going into the next week. And as you see, we're facing off against Texas State, who's one of the sorriest teams on the game. But unfortunately, nobody is worse than us as far as our ratings. But that doesn't matter at all. These Bobcats are going down. Let's get it. It's a road game. And as you see, we're getting pumped up. We have a chance. You know, obviously, that they don't know what's going on prior to when I started playing. But, you know, it's a feeling in the air, something that, you know, we have a chance to do something special today, become a top two ranked team and have a chance just to win out and play for a national title. As you see, hashtag Texas State. They don't want to see us, though. Why would a Texas State quarterback be doing the Heisman? I don't know, but that's neither here nor there, I guess. As you see, they're trying to beef with us. But we're not going to get stopped by anybody. We're going to play hard and do our best to get all the way to the ship and get that achievement. But we're in week eight. You know, that's a long ways away, so I'm not worried about that now until the end of the season. Hopefully, we're undefeated by the time the end of the season comes. Anyway, we like to kick off the ball because we won the toss, and we kick it off to Texas State, so we're going to see what they have. For some reason, every team in the Sun Belt has a scrambling QB, and it's very annoying because our team is not good at all, even though we made a great tackle for loss there. But our team just isn't very good against the run, the pass either, really. But, I mean, I do a good enough job to cover the middle of the field, and our DBs always play bump and run coverage. But stopping the run is just so impossible. As you saw in the video a couple games ago, as they go down the field and pick up a great first down, great pass, what can you do? But a couple videos ago, I played Alabama, and T.J. Yeldon was just tearing us a new ass because good running backs just make us pay. There's nothing we could do about it. And every team in our conference as well always runs no huddle. I don't know why. With teams with like 70s and 68 overall ratings, it makes no sense. But it gives us a chance to get after the quarterback. I ran great coverage there, and our guys did a good job sticking their receivers, allowing Bill Overstreet to pick up his first sack of the day. Now they're facing a 3rd and 14, and we're going to run some more of that quarter defense. This is what I play out of generally just because, you know, I want to play a spy just in case they try to scramble out of the pocket. Completes a pass across the middle, but not nearly enough for the first down. So 4th down, looks like they're going to punt, right? Wrong. For some reason, all the teams in our conference also go for it on 4th down instead of punting it whenever they're on our side of the field. I don't know if they don't trust their punter or they just have that much confidence in their offense, but whatever. He's going down the field. We make a play with Jenkins, and we knock the ball down, forcing a turnover on downs already. And now it's our turn. We're in the shotgun ourselves. Justin Royals at quarterback, looking to do what he's been doing all season long, finding the open man and making great passes. As you see, he's got decent enough speed, about a 75, and he scrambles out to the outside for a big first down to continue the drive on that 3rd and 7. Minute and 45 left to go in the first quarter. Still not at a zero. Now, fast forward a little bit, 31 seconds left to go in the first quarter. Going across the middle, finding my boy Jeff Smith, who's been one of our early season MVPs, who's done an absolutely amazing job extending drives, catching touchdowns, and doing the damn thing. That was actually the last play of the first quarter for us. And the number three Georgia State Panthers and the Texas State Bobcats are knotted at zeros. Bunch of goose eggs, but we're driving and threatening to score already. But look at this. I ran a couple plays, and we're already at 3rd and 25. Looking like we're not going to get much of anything. We're going to go up the field, and we get picked off by Soul, the linebacker, I believe. Oh, he might be a corner, I'm not sure. But we throw right into coverage because that's just what I do. I'm not very smart when it comes to those 3rd and long situations. Probably should have just you know, tried to get some short yardage and went for a field goal. But our kicker sucks too, so we probably would have gone for it. Anyway, now they get the ball, just under 4.5 minutes to play in the second quarter. They run a little screen pass, but we are not to be fooled, forcing a 3rd and 10, 3rd and long, looking to make the stop. And let's see what happens. Running the basic quarter defense, five DBs, rushing three defensive linemen. You know, I'm playing spy just to make sure they have no reason to go down the field and scramble on us. And that was actually an incomplete pass. So now it's 4th and 10, and they punted it to us after a pretty good return. We're set up already in their in their territory, looking to knock on the door. And I go down the field looking for a touchdown. Sheldon Jefferson. Wow, great pass by Justin Royal. Sheldon Jefferson just could not hold on to it, which is a shame because that was actually one of the few good passes we're able to make, and our receivers are kind of, you know, bad. So I don't know. But now it's 3rd and 8, and we go up the field to John Beck, the hero against, I believe that was Alabama. He got that game-winning touchdown. Gets a 3rd and long catch for 23 yards, setting us up with a 1st and goal. Couple plays later, 2nd and goal, we're going to our boy. First time of the day, we're going to call his name out, Martell Jones. Running to the left side off tackle. Going to get in the end zone for yet another touchdown. 3 yards out. Let's go. Martell Jones is on the fast track of being, you know, an All-American. He's got a ton of touchdowns, averaging about 5-6 yards a carry. And, yeah, go Georgia State. Now just under 2 minutes to play. They're facing a 3rd and 4, Texas State that is. And they're running some more of that no huddle with the clock running. We're trying to get the ball back and stop the clock, hopefully to get the ball one more time to, you know, go score before the half. But they run a screen play, which I'm normally on top of those. But for some reason, I wasn't looking for it. So they got it off on me. But what can you do? Oh, well. They're still running that no huddle. We're in that. We're actually in, I want to say, the dollar defense right now. No, we're still in the quarter. Just they have a 3-wide receiver set, and we force a fumble, and Bill Overstreet falls on it and gets the first down, setting us up deep in their territory with just over a minute and a half to play. Jermaine Walton, remember that name. He set the school record for sacks in the season, even though it's only 5. He broke that, but he's gonna have a great season, let me tell you right now. And yeah, just keep an eye out for that guy. He's doing a great job for us, you know, getting after the quarterbacks in our division. Did a good job slowing down Johnny Football, Braxton Miller, etc. whenever we played them. And now 3rd and 5, just under 50 seconds to play. Looking to extend this drive, score another touchdown or something, keep it going. Going across the middle to Dallas McKinney. This guy, oh my God, he is a coach's dream and a nightmare at the same time. He drops so many passes, but he just comes up in clutch situations. He always, you know, always scores. So I don't know. It's tough to deal with guys who make drops all the time, but you got to trust them because it's all we got. Now, 2nd and goal, we drop it off to Jeff Smith, who's in for yet another touchdown in the season. 2 yards out, and just like that, we're up 14-0. It's going to be the final play of the first half. 3 seconds to go. Nothing else is going to happen. So, 14-0 at the half. We're in pretty dominating shape, even though it's a 2-touchdown lead. Texas State is having a very hard time advancing the ball up and down the field, as you see. They only have 51 yards passing, negative 6 yards rushing. We're actually one of the top 3 ranked teams in the country as far as run defense. Now, simming ahead, we're actually backed up in their territory. They're actually knocking on the door of the red zone, but we slow them down. There's that tough run defense once again, setting them back to a 2nd and 13. But they're still on their on our side of the field, looking to score or at least get in scoring range. You know, they probably wouldn't kick a field goal from here, but we'll see what happens. 3rd and 15, we're back in that quarter defense because that's all we play, like I said, just because we got to slow down all the passing offenses in our division. And look at this. Look at this play. Runs yet another screen pass, almost breaks it for a big run, getting the first down. But instead, it's 4th and 5. Maybe it's a field goal attempt. Yes, they're going to go for the field goal. They're not going to go for the 4th down conversion this time because it was unsuccessful the previous time. So now it's 14-3. Georgia State gets the ball back, 2nd and 4. We're going to run the ball with Martell Jones, who's been doing such a great job at this game. See if we can get a look at what he's got so far. Gets the 1st down, nice cut in, picks up 12 more yards, and sets the team record for rushing yards in the season with 750-plus on the year already. So I'm going to look to establish a much higher record since we're only in our 7th game of the season, and you know, make it difficult for guys next year and the year on and so on and so forth after Martell Jones graduates this year. Now, same drive. It's 2nd and inches. We go across the field, and there's that guy again, the coach's dream. Dallas McKinney picks up the 1st down, extending the drive, and that would actually be the final play of the 2nd quarter. 14-3. We're still leading, still dominating, threatening to put this game out of reach already on the first possession of the 4th quarter. So let's see what happens. While this is going on, I want to talk about Johnny Football, you know, what's going on with him. You know, keep an eye on the game while I'm talking. But I want to talk about what's going on with him. This game was recorded, or this video was recorded on Saturday the 31st, so pretty much the opening weekend of college football, and they played Rice, whatever. We expected them to blow him out. But this kid, I don't understand him at all. I mean, you know, I knew he comes from, you know, I knew he came from a really rich upbringing and probably spoiled and, you know, all that good stuff. But the way this kid acts is just hilarious. You know, just got questioned as Sheldon Jefferson drops his second touchdown of the day, or his second touchdown catch drop, whatever, leading us to a field goal, only allowing us to extend the lead to a 2-touchdown lead instead of a 3-score lead. But whatever. But yeah, just I watched the game against Rice, or watched some of the highlights, and he was forced to sit out the first half for the quote-unquote investigation into his autograph signing, you know, fiasco, which, you know, that's another video for another time. I completely believe it's BS, you know, the way he got off and whatever. I don't care. I really don't care. Anyway, as you can tell, I obviously do care, just because, you know, I'm a guy who likes the sanctity and the purity of sports, and guys who cheat like A-Rod and all that. It just makes me mad, because, you know, I wanted to be an athlete growing up and I just wasn't good enough, you know, but whatever. And those who take advantage of it and cheat and all that, just, you know, it just sullies the game, but whatever. Anyway, Johnny Football, the stuff he was doing today, you know, doing the autograph signing, you know, little motion or whatever, just, I don't know, this kid's a clown. His coach needs to get a hold of him and just talk to him and something. Somebody needs to say something. His dad went ahead and he talked to, I think it was ESPN he talked to, about somebody needs to help my son. He's going off on the deep end. Well, you're his father. Do something about it. I mean, you know, stop enabling this kid. He was driving a freaking Mercedes-Benz on campus as a freshman last year. You know, and I'm not somebody who's going to tell you how to spend your money or whatever, but just think about it. This kid's out of control. He's doing all kind of dumb stuff. And where were you when he was flying to New York and Miami and all that, signing autographs, 4,500 of them or however many it was? You know, where were you at? You know, I know he's a 19-year-old, 20-year-old, you know, man pretty much. But still, you know, keep an eye on your kids. As you see, we're going to wrap this game up 17-3. Not the most impressive victory at all. But, yeah, let me know what you think in the comment section about Johnny Football and them. I still expect him to be a Heisman finalist because he's a great talent. You know, you can't knock him at all for that. Bill Overstreet, shout-outs to him, player of the game. But I don't know. What do you guys think? What's wrong with this kid? Can anybody help him? Can anybody, you know, serve as a mentor? He went to the freaking Peyton Manning quarterback camp and screwed that up. So if Peyton Manning can get to you and he's, you know, the best there is pretty much as far as quarterbacks and a guy who makes no mistakes off the field and all that good stuff, or at least keeps it out of the public eye, what do you think can happen with Johnny Football? I don't know. But this is your boy, I'll pull up to the house. Video is wrapping up. We moved to 8-0. We're going to move to the – or 7-0. We're going to move to the number 2 spot in the nation. So stay tuned. Like, comment, subscribe if you're new. And I'm gone. Peace.